जय हिंद एवरीवन, वेलकम टू क्लास ऑफ इकोनॉमिक्स। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, द चैप्टर विच इज गोइंग ऑन इज पीपल एज रिसोर्स एंड वी हैव डिस्कस्ड मेनी टॉपिक्स इन दिस चैप्टर। इकोनॉमिक एक्टिविटीज लाइक प्राइमरी, सेकेंडरी एंड टर्शियरी सेक्टर्स। देन वी डिस्कस्ड दैट हाउ इन्वेस्टमेंट इन टर्म्स ऑफ education, health and training can make a population an asset than liability. And in previous period we have discussed about education, and today we have to discuss about health. So dear students, it is my humble request that please open the book, this chapter and health section. So let's start today's class. So dear students, now we are going to start the chapter People as Resource, and today's topic is health. So we have to know about health. Dear students, firm maximize profit. For example, if you have established any firm, any industry, what will be main motive? That is to maximize profit. So do you think any firm would be induced to employ people who might not work efficiently as healthy workers because of ill health? It is very easy to understand. Suppose you have established an industry, so to whom you will try to employ? The people who are physically and mentally fit. The persons who are not fit, not healthy, you will not employ them. What is the reason behind this? Because an unhealthy person cannot work efficiently like healthy persons. That's why you will employ a person that is healthy. So, dear students, health, the health of a person helps him to realize his or her potential and the ability to fight illness. Kya hai health of a person? That helps him to realize his or her potential and the ability to fight illness. He or she will not be able to maximize his or her output to the overall growth of the organization. Suppose if someone is unhealthy, then his or her productivity will be less, and he or she will not be able to maximize his or her output or productivity to the overall growth of the organization. Indeed, health is an indispensable basis for realizing one's well-being. So you can understand that how much important health is for your own and for any organization also. Henceforth, improvement in the health status of the population has been the priority of the country. It is very easy to understand, if the people of any country will be healthy, then they will be more productive. And if they will be more productive, then it will help in the economical development of the country, dear students. So, improvement in the health status of the population has been the priority of the country, like education. That's why government of any country works a lot, spend a lot on the health facilities of the population. And for India, it is very true. So, dear students, our national policy too aims at improving the accessibility of healthcare, family welfare, and nutritional service with a special focus on the underprivileged segment of the population. According to our national policy, it is the target of our national policy, it is the aim of our national policy to improve the condition of, or you can say, accessibility of healthcare so that everyone can get health facilities provided by the government. It is for family welfare and it is for nutritional services. And where this policy is focusing, that is the section of underprivileged population. And government is working a lot on this. Over the last 50 years, 5 decades, India has built a vast health infrastructure and has also developed the manpower required at primary, secondary, and tertiary sector in government as well as in the private sector. So we can say from last 50 years, the health facilities provided by the government has improved a lot. And you know, India has built a vast infrastructure of health, developing the manpower, you know, that is required at any sector like primary, secondary, and tertiary, even in government and in the private sector. So it is very important. And that's why India's government or our 5-year plans, they are focusing on health facilities provided by the government also. Then, these measures which have been adopted have increased the life expectancy to over 68.3 years in 2014. Many measures have adopted, and what was the advantage of this? Life expectancy has increased to over 68.3 years in 2014. What is life expectancy? At the time of birth, it is expected that how many years a person will live. That is life expectancy. That is average. So that is 68.3 years in 2014. Then infant mortality rate, commonly known as IMR. It has come down from 147 in 1951 to 37 in 2015. So, dear students, now the question is, what is infant mortality rate? So, it is a rate of those live birth, it is the proportion of those children who die before completion of 1 year. It is the rate of those child who die before completion of 1 year, proportion to all live births in that particular year. That is infant mortality rate. इसको ऐसे भी समझना है कि जितने बच्चों ने जन्म लिया किसी भी पर्टिकुलर ईयर में, उसमें से कितने बच्चे 1 year कंप्लीट करने से पहले डाई कर जाते हैं. एंड दैट इज नोन एज IMR. Infant mortality rate. So it was 147 in 1951. It means 1951 mein 147 children jo hai, they died before completion of 1 year. And now it reduced to 37 in 2015. So these measures, lots of health facilities, medical facilities were provided by the government, and this is the result. Then crude birth rates have dropped to 20.8 and death rates to 6.5 within the same duration of time. Birth rates, how many children born in any particular year, then total number of children, how many children born and life born to the total number of children in any particular year, and it is same for the death rates. So crude birth rates have dropped to 20.8 and death rates to 6.5 within the same duration of time. So many measures have been adopted by the government, and this is the result. What is the result? That life expectancy to over 68.3 years in 2014, IMR, infant mortality rate, has come down from 147 in 1951 to 37 in 2015. Crude birth rates have dropped to 20.8 and death rates to 6.5 within the same duration of time. So this is the positive result of measures taken by the government. So increase in life expectancy and improvement in child care, they are useful in assessing the future progress of the country. And if people will live more and if there will be proper child care, then it will help a lot in the progress of country. Increase in longevity of life, I'm talking about life expectancy. So increase in longevity of life is an indicator of good quality of life marked by self-confidence. अगर लॉन्गेविटी ऑफ लाइफ इंक्रीज होगा, इट मींस अगर लोग किसी कंट्री में ज्यादा समय तक जीवित रहेंगे, तो ये एक बहुत अच्छा इंडिकेटर है, एंड इट इंडिकेट्स द गुड क्वालिटी ऑफ लाइफ, एंड इट विल बी मार्क्ड बाय सेल्फ कॉन्फिडेंस. देन रिडक्शन इन इन्फेंट मोर्टेलिटी रेट, अगर इन्फेंट मोर्टेलिटी रेट रिड्यूस करेगा, तो इट इन्वॉल्व्स द प्रोटेक्शन ऑफ चिल्ड्रेन फ्रॉम इन्फेक्शन एंड श्योरिंग द न्यूट्रिशन ऑफ बोथ द मदर एंड द चाइल्ड एंड चाइल्ड केयर. डियर स्टूडेंट्स, बहुत सारे बच्चे केवल इसलिए डाई कर जाते हैं क्योंकि वो जब जन्म लेते हैं तो उन्हें किसी तरह का इन्फेक्शन हो जाता है, उनमें न्यूट्रिशन की कमी हो जाती है, एंड दैट इज द रीजन ऑफ IMR, इन्फेंट मोर्टेलिटी रेट. तो इन्फेंट मोर्टेलिटी रेट जितना भी रिड्यूस होगा, वो ये शो करेगा कि व्हाट इज द कंडीशन ऑफ हेल्थ फैसिलिटीज गिवन बाय गवर्नमेंट टू द चिल्ड्रेन एंड मदर्स ऑफ द कंट्री. सो रिडक्शन इन IMR इन्वॉल्व्स द प्रोटेक्शन ऑफ चिल्ड्रेन फ्रॉम इन्फेक्शन, एंश्योरिंग द न्यूट्रिशन ऑफ बोथ द मदर एंड द चाइल्ड एंड चाइल्ड केयर. After that, there are many places in India which do not have even these basic facilities. बहुत सारी जगह है इंडिया में जहां पर even ये basic facilities available नहीं है. There are only 381 medical colleges in the country and 301 dental colleges. Dear students, आपके पूरे country में, I'm talking about India, there are only 381 medical colleges and 301 dental colleges. As you know that India is a vast country. In area wise, it is at 7th position. And if we will talk about the population, then it is second most populous country of the world. But we are having only 381 medical colleges and 301 डेंटल कॉलेजेस. और प्रॉब्लम यही नहीं खत्म होती, जस्ट फोर स्टेट्स. अब ये देखो कि ये जितने भी मेडिकल कॉलेजेस या डेंटल कॉलेजेस हैं, ज्यादातर कहां है? सो जस्ट फोर स्टेट्स लाइक आंध्र प्रदेश, कर्नाटका, महाराष्ट्र एंड तमिलनाडु हैव द मैक्सिमम नंबर ऑफ कॉलेजेस. सो वी हैव 381 मेडिकल कॉलेजेस, 301 डेंटल कॉलेजेस. देन ऑल्सो ज्यादातर जो मेडिकल कॉलेजेस हैं, डेंटल कॉलेजेस हैं, वो या तो आंध्र प्रदेश, कर्नाटका, महाराष्ट्र और तमिलनाडु में हैं. What about other states? So there is need to establish more and more medical and dental colleges and even to each and every states of India. There should be a uniformity. Then everyone will be benefited from this. Clear? Now the next segment is unemployment. है ना, आपने कई बार सुना होगा अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट के बारे में. सो द क्वेश्चन इज व्हाट इज अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट. सो जस्ट रिकॉल द स्टोरीज ऑफ सकल एंड बिलास. सो सकल्स मदर शीला लुक्ड आफ्टर द डोमेस्टिक कोर्स चिल्ड्रेन एंड हेल्प्ड हर हस्बैंड बूटा इन द फील्ड. सकल्स ब्रदर जीतू एंड सिस्टर सीतू स्पेंड दियर टाइम प्लेइंग एंड रोमिंग. सो नाउ द क्वेश्चन इज कैन यू कॉल शीला और जीतू और सीतू अनएम्प्लॉयड. क्या आप शीला, जीतू या सीतू को अनएम्प्लॉयड कह सकते हैं? और अगर नहीं कह सकते, इफ नॉट देन वॉट इज द रीजन? सो लेट्स स्टार्ट टू अंडरस्टैंड. अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट इज सेड टू एग्जिस्ट वेन people who are willing to work at the going wages cannot find jobs. Just keep it in your mind always. किसको आप unemployed कहेंगे? What is unemployment? So it is said to exist when people who are willing to work, just mind it, वो जो काम करना चाहे, willing to work, एट द प्रिवेलिंग वेजेस, जो भी वेजेस है, बट नॉट गेटिंग जॉब, दैट दे विल बी अनएम्प्लॉयड एंड दैट इज द कंडीशन ऑफ अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट. दैट यू हैव टू कीप इट इन योर माइंड. इफ यू वॉन्ट टू डू द वर्क, इफ यू आर विलिंग टू डू द वर्क एट प्रिवेलिंग वेजेस बट यू आर नॉट गेटिंग जॉब, देन यू आर अनएम्प्लॉयड. बट सपोज करो मैं काम नहीं करना चाहता, आई डोंट वॉन्ट टू डू जॉब, and then I am not getting the job, definitely I will not get the job, then I will not come under unemployed. So that criteria you have to keep it in your mind, that unemployment is said to exist when people who are willing to work at prevailing wages and not finding the job, that is unemployment. Sheila is not interested in working outside her domestic domain. Jitu and Situ are too small to be counted in the workforce population. ठीक है, शीला बाहर का कोई काम नहीं करना चाहती, Jitu and Situ are very small, they cannot be counted in the workforce of the population. Neither Jitu, Situ or Sheila can be counted as unemployed. ठीक है, Jitu, Situ या Sita, sorry Sheila, they can be counted as, they cannot be counted as unemployed. Unko unemployed nahi kahenge. You know what is the age group of working population? So the age group of working population is from 15 years to 59 years. Theek hai? So if you are willing to do the job at prevailing wages and not getting any job, not finding any job, then you will be termed as unemployed. That's why Sheila cannot be termed as unemployed. And Jitu and Situ, they are very small, so they cannot be counted as unemployed. Then, the workforce population, dear students, includes people from 15 years to 59 years. Maine kaha tha na, workforce population ka age group kya hai? 15 years to 59 years. Why it is started from 15 years? Because till 14 years, इट इज योर राइट टू गेट एजुकेशन एंड यू कैन नॉट बी एम्प्लॉयड. And the highest is 59 years because after that they got retired. So the work, the age group of workforce population of India is 15 years to 59 years. Sakal's brother and sister do not fall within this age group. Sakal ke brother or sister is age group mein nahi aate. They are less than 15 years. So they cannot be called unemployed. Sakal's mother Sheila works for the family. She is not willing to work outside her domestic domain for payment. वो payment के लिए बाहर काम नहीं करना चाहती. तो because she is not willing to work outside, she will not be counted as unemployed. Sakal's grandparents, Sakal's grandparents, actually they are not mentioned in the story. They cannot be called unemployed because they are more than 59 years. So just try to understand what is unemployment, who are unemployed. So the persons or any person who is willing to work at prevailing wages but not getting any job will be termed as unemployed. And there is age group of working population that is from 15 years to 59 years. So dear students, it was the topics which we discussed. Okay, so we discussed about health and we discussed about unemployment. In health, I have given you many measures adopted by the government to improve the health condition of the country, and I said that it is the priority of any country. It should be priority of any country. So the people of that country should be healthy because they are more productive and they will help a lot in the development of the country. Then we started unemployment. Dear students, unemployment, anyone who is willing to do the work, जो काम करना चाहता है at prevailing wages, जो भी wages उस समय prevail है उस wages पे काम करना चाहता है but not getting the job, that is unemployment. In next period or next class we will discuss about different types of unemployment. Till then it is my humble request to each and everyone, please read the chapter or the topics carefully. Till then, thank you and have a nice day.